my eyes is a desert of stone and ice. The surface red like Mars as the winds flow in galactic times, where no one ever found the crying winds it sound. Was it really once a land and the life it might have held?
What flourished here before? Wasteland, wasteland. I wanna make it to the end, but the roofs and the sand are electrified, and I'm tied to the pole, still energized.
We should really stop producing more nuclear waste because we don't have a clue where to put it. You would never get into a plane if you don't have a landing place. We have to make society ready to take decisions. We have to do discussions about it, what people really think we should do with the waste, because the coming generations, they will be responsible for the waste that their generations before had been producing. We do not need nuclear energy. It is really dirty, starting with uranium mining. It is really expensive. It never worked without subsidies, with really huge subsidies. It is very dangerous, not only because of the waste, but also because of accidents and also because of the radiation that is normal each and every day around the plants, around the storages. And it is too slow. We need the energy not in 35 years from new nuclear plants. We need it now, and we can take it from renewable energies. So we don't need it, and we should really change into a new age now.
One answer would be there is a nuclear mafia. It's a very big business. And imagine this very big industry, lots of people involved. Second half of the 20th century, after World War II, industry started like in 70s, dozens of reactors across the world built. Industry is booming. A lot of governmental subsidies coming to the industry, and they living very good. I mean, they have very good salaries. People think that they are the future. And people don't know that much as they know today about radiation exposure and the problems it may cause to health. They don't know about different problems associated with nuclear power, also about nuclear waste, for example. Everybody thinks we finally solved the energy problem. Then in a couple of decades after this, it appears that reactors may actually explode, and they may contaminate thousands of square kilometers where it would be impossible to live. They can actually cause deadly diseases. Lots of, you know, different types of cancers and other deadly things. So in the end, we arrived to the situation when society got the new knowledge. It finally understood after a couple of decades or two or three decades, it finally understood that this is a very dangerous thing, that it have a lot of serious limitations. Society finally understood that there is a lot of problems we have to do about it, something about it. But by this time, industry already so big, so expensive, it's so rich, it has a lot of political lobbyists. It actually connected to nuclear weapon as well, and to many governments, it's very important, nuclear weapon things. So in the end, yes, society started to understand what kind of big problems there is, but nuclear industry is very hard to fight, because it's so powerful from political point of view, from financial point of view, it has its lobbyists everywhere, and in the end, if critics will be on a very high level, they can always say, well, in those countries that have nuclear weapons, for example, they will always say, like, hey, we are your protection. We prepare a nuclear weapon for you so you can be protected and no one attack you. What is good about the 21st century or beginning of 21st century that we're living in is that most of the reactors that exist now and in operation across the world coming to an end of their lifetime now. So in the closest decade, a very big number of reactors will go offline. In the closest two decades, even bigger amount of reactors, actually the majority of reactors will go offline. That would be ideal time to change energy policy on a global level, to change basically the way we develop our energy industries across the world, because, well, why would we build a new expensive nuclear reactors to replace old when renewable energy is booming? It's getting cheaper and cheaper and cheaper every year, not like nuclear reactors getting more expensive every year. So I think we have a very good opportunity. So now, really, time is coming when reactors will go offline just because it's very, very old. And now it's the time to make our effort to stop finally the development of nuclear power industry and basically push for the phase out worldwide.
We have to see how very little nuclear power plants are being allowed and built anymore. Yeah, so there is a continuous decline. Sometimes in some years worldwide, only one single nuclear power plant was put on the grid, while several taken off. So this is an unstoppable decline of the industry, with really severe consequences already, which is that it seems that their abilities to design, build, and start operating a plant are so low that, for example, those three or four construction sites we have in Europe now are just never ending. Yeah, we have the plant of Mochovce, which is years behind, the European pressurized reactor in Flamanville and in Olkiluoto. They are 6, 7, 8 years behind schedule, and perhaps they never really finish because there is just so many problems because the industry is not performing well. It's so complex that they don't even know what really can happen. So they have completely unforeseen so-called accident sequences. Yeah. So you have a certain overview of what kind of catastrophes could happen with your mixer at home. Yeah. So there has several things. But with nuclear power plants, it's completely crazy what causes what kind of sequences. So it's utterly unreliable energy source. Actually the most dangerous, and where in reality most of our efforts go into these days, is not those few new reactors which might or might not be built, but it's the lifetime extension of operating reactors. So this is old reactors from 30, 40 years ago, and they want to extend this to work 10 or 20 more years. And I think this is the biggest safety threat. And because the industry is so much down and electricity prices are so much down, they want to do this really as cheap as possible. And I think this is a very big safety threat.
De egy másik elgondolkodtató szempont az, hogy bár csak néhány évtizede működnek a világon atomerőművek, Magyarországon jó 30 éve, már most egészen elképesztő mennyiségű atomszemetet termeltek ki. Tehát ez a pár évvel ezelőtti adat, ez a 270 ezer tonna, ez szerintem egy felfoghatatlan mennyiségű szemét adag, és ez csak néhány évtized eredménye. Tehát ha most belegondolunk, hogy azt mondjuk, hogy az atomerőművel hosszú távon számolunk, 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, mondjuk 1000 évvel, ugye, hogy az atomenergia az egy megkerülhetetlen legyen az emberiség jövőjében, akkor abban is bele kell gondolnunk, hogy ez az atom szemét mennyiség, ami már most a nyakunkon van, és már most nem tudunk vele mit csinálni, csak terveink vannak az, hogy mit fogunk vele csinálni, az hatványozódni fog, és én azt gondolom, hogy előbb-utóbb el fog élni egy olyan kritikus adatot, amikor le kell látnia még a nukleár globális pártiaknak is, hogy ez egy olyan szemét mennyiség, amivel nem lehet mit kezdeni. Tehát a Föld nem tud ennyi mindent benyelni, hiszen azok a meteorológiai tározók, amelyekre szükség van ilyen fűtőelemek tárolására, csak speciális környezetben építhetőek, nem építhetőek bárhol. Tehát nyilván vannak olyan országok, ahol nem lehet ilyet megépíteni.
Tudjuk azt, hogy a németek leállították az atomerőművek problémáját. Ma már ettől korszerűbb eszközök is rendelkezésre állnak, ugye a szélerőművek, naperőművek, bioenergia, tehát nagyon sok olyan energia van. Most lehet, hogy most mi erről beszélünk, de 20 év múlva kinevetjük saját magunkat, hogy mondjuk ilyen primitív dolgokat használnak emberek, mint például egy veszélyes atomerőmű.
So I conclude that with current technologies and all the technologies on the drawing board at the moment, nuclear power is simply not safe for humans to handle and it cannot be made safe. Perhaps there is a future technology that may be invented by the next generation. So yes, we need to invest in research, if only in order to find the technologies that we need in order to decommission the nuclear plants and deal with the waste. But in the meantime, we have all the renewable energies that are getting cheaper every year. The cost of solar panels is falling by 40% or something like that. It's coming down amazingly. So we don't have to wait for anything. We can now, for economic reasons alone, promote renewable energy, and we don't need to build nuclear power plants anywhere in the world.
When the Greens then became a member of the federal government in 1998, this was one of our most important goals, to start phasing out nuclear energy and to kick off an alternative energy revolution. And a lot of so-called experts said it is impossible to make renewable energy the backbone of the German energy system. This is just a kind of green utopia. This is completely unrealistic. The Red-Green coalition made a really, I would say, a historic decision to establish the feed-in tariff law, giving investments in solar and wind energy a long-term security of the return on investment. And this created a completely new market for renewable energies in Germany, and not only in Germany. De facto, you could say that the German feed-in tariff law enabled the build-up of the Chinese solar industry. So it is true that at the beginning, renewable energies had been quite expensive. But now we see grid parity, so competitiveness, especially of solar in southern regions and wind in the coast region there. Meanwhile, they have become competitive with coal-fired plants or the gas, than energy cheap plants without state subsidies. So, I would say this is the main success of this green than energy story. This is all about, I would say, a huge wave of innovation, creating new technologies, new services. New companies are coming up. It's an enormous opportunity for startups. So this renewable energy sector is rapidly growing. If only the markets would decide, there will be no single new nuclear power plant globally.
Wasteland, wasteland, I wanna make it to the end. But the roofs and the sand are electrified, and I'm tied to the